Okay, earthlings, today, tomato soup. Now, I've been watching, I'm still working, you know, she's the queen of canning. I ordained her myself. Anyway, I'm kind of deviating from the recipe a little bit because I have to use up some veg. So I've got 3 green bell peppers, 2 humongous onions, 1 carrot, and 2 cups of celery. And I'm going to cook them to death. Okay, so I'm going to tell you about my mamaters after I put some light on the subject. Okay, we got these cans of tomatoes. Can you see that? No. Simply Value whole peeled tomatoes. I have no idea what's in the can. I opened it, but I was waiting for you before I took the lid off. So, here's the thing. I lost about 2 hours worth of videos today. I'm so upset. Stupid flip. Oh, they look okay. Let's see. A little plums. Little bitty plums. Okay, so I put the food strainer vegetable smoosher attachment on to the KitchenAid, and what happens is the good stuff comes out here and things you don't want to eat comes out here. However, you can run the reject pieces through the hopper. You can run it through again, so extract all the juice possible. So let's see how this works. All right. Hungry was just pricing flips online. Oh, they're so expensive. Not like in the olden days. Okay, so you put the tomatoes up on this itty-bitty tray. One of these days I'm going to invest in a real tray. Just dump them in there. And turn the KitchenAid up to 4. Oh yeah, the KitchenAid is so old. Yellow likes to hear this noise. Okay, so just dump them in there. The new KitchenAid attachments have a pusher unscrewer thingy, but mine's old, so it has one of these. Let's see what happens. Ooh, sounds rude. Can you see it starting to drip right here into my measure? Let's see. I'll be making a real mess. No, you can't see. Okay, but Hungry's going down the office or something. Alright, keep you down. Poor Flip. That's why he's dead. He's got a ton of food stuck in him. Okay, so the good stuff comes out here. Okay. And the rejects come out here. That is pretty dry, but I will run it through again because I'm so cheap. Did I tell you that these tomatoes were only $1.49 a can? We got a ton of them. Well, not a ton, but like, how many? 2, 4, 7 of them. You can run this faster if you want, but I can't because I'm not that coordinated. And you know, I have to straddle my tripod. So I'm going to just squish a few more hundred down here. And then I'll be back because, see that? I would buy these tomatoes again. They're not so bad. Okay. Be right back. Okay. So this is one can. There's some juice in there. I'll strain it before I put it in there. And I've got all this pulp and a humongous mess. This job, you have to do a lot at once, or else I just can't believe you'd have to wear out your kitchen cleaning it. All right, so poor Flip. Never in the house again. Never, ever. I'm too short. Can't see what I'm doing. Oh well. Okay, I'm taking all this pulpy junk, skin and seeds and whatever, spores, and I'm going to put them right through the hopper again. This is still a little bit of... Anyway, so you can see the consistency of it. It still feels wet. So, we'll run it through again. See if we can get anything out of it. A little bit. A lot, actually. Uh-oh. I dropped a big blob in there. So I'm still working, uses a Victorio, which is a nice machine. My grandfather had one. I don't know who ended up with it when they broke the house down, but I would love to have that thing. But then, little by little, I started investing in KitchenAid stuff, and Hungry one day just decided to buy me every attachment known to mankind. He got me every attachment except the ice cream thingy, which I kind of would like to have, because our little ice cream thing only makes about 3 cups at a time. Okay, let's go over here. Not very wet at all. Oops. Not at all. It took a lot more juice out. Okay, so, can you see up in there? You know, I'm way too short for this job. If I was like 5'3", I think I could reach it without having to hold my arm up. And I could see what I was doing. All right. Okay, I'll put Flip down and clean tomatoes out of his guts. Okay, so after running it through twice, this is the waste I got out of that 6 pound, 6 ounce can. I got way more good stuff than will fit in here. Why did I put the strainer in there? I wanted to see if it would be more refined. It really isn't. Okay, so that's one can down. Altogether, probably took me 3 or 4 minutes, but only because I'm short. I honestly think that's the only reason. And messy. So, let me clean this mess up and I'll try can number 2. See, it's really quite dry. Can't really squeeze anything out of that. That's it. Nothing in here but the seeds and the skin and the cores and the nasty bits you wouldn't want to eat anyway. Gooder than the Foley food mill, only because of my bum arm and hand and stuff. But yeah, I'm very happy with this. I love my KitchenAid, the beast. So when these are completely and totally soft, I'm going to stick the Wizamigator in there. Whoop them all up. Oh, I keep forgetting. I can't see what you're seeing. I'm going to whiz them up and push them through the strainer. And I'll add in the tomatoes. Beautifully de-seeded, de-skinned, de-cored, and smooth as a baby's rattle. So I'll do that and we will see if I have enough, or if I have to do 2 cans to make this recipe. I'm doing them in pints for Hungry's lunch, So I've got 8, 12, 14. And I'm going to use the little guy because it's too cold and windy outside today. It's 37 or 8 degrees. You can't can with that plus 10 mile an hour winds. It'll affect the pressure inside the canner. Okay, so I had used my Whizamigator to puree the veggies. I strained them and put them in with the tomatoes. I used two of those big old cans of tomatoes. Got my jars keeping hot. And now I'm going to add, this is 8 tablespoons of clear gel, 3/4 cup of sugar. I used white sugar. And I've got, what did I do with that? Oh, here it is. This is white vinegar, 3 tablespoons. And I need some cold water, so I'll be right back. Thick. Just cold water. If you use hot, it'll clump up on you. So just keep stirring it smooth. How much cold water? I don't know. I think it's probably 1/3 cup, maybe. Now, the tomatoes are not really salty, but I'm not going to put a lot of salt in here. The recipe says 2 tablespoons if you want it. I'm going to use 1. Okay. Boiling. Then I'm going to stir it in. Stir it up. It's kind of gunky on the bottom there. And bring it back to a boil until it's clear. And then I'll get ready to pressure can these. I'm doing pints. Hungry's listening to the aftermath of the Super Bowl.
Well, you should see this.
Wait, honey, I'm on Mr. Flip right now. Okie dokie, so it's coming back to a boil, ready to can. I just did a little sneak taste test, and I think it's sweet. I think I would cut back on the sugar next time. I don't know. Yeah, it's a little sweet. There's 8 pints in there, so I'm going to double stack the next layer. You can do that without a rack. I just don't like to. Anyway, so you just stagger them. You don't put them directly on top. You stagger them, but I'll show you. So that's how I stagger them. There you go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 16 pints. 16 pints. Okay, a 10-minute vent. I'll put the weight on. And then we'll let it come up to 11 pounds. And pints go for 20 minutes. 11 pounds on a dial gauge. 10 pounds on a weighted gauge. All those Tatler lids, but one throwaway. Don't tip the jars when you take them out. I don't know, I just follow the rules. Okay, so we don't tighten that, but let me see. Stay Flip. The tatlers you have to scrunch down because that's the rules. I'm a rule follower. So I had a place all set up on the breakfast bar to do this, but somebody put their dinner there. Okay, I'm going to keep taking them out and not bore you. There they sit. We heard the little familiar ping on the one that I'm going to give to my friend, the crafty lady, because it's the only way she can get vegetables from her husband. Well, Earthlings, I just got a phone call from one of my taste testers, and she said this soup was not the best soup she ever had, but it was the best thing she ever put in her mouth. And it's a good way to sneak those veggies into her husband. I have one more taste tester out, but we're hoping that she's going to feel the same way. I thought the soup was a little sweet when I finished, you know, adding all the ingredients. And when I popped it yesterday and sent it off to work with Hungry Hubby, it mellowed so much. It was absolutely delicious. He called me from work twice to tell me how good it was. So give it a try. Here's what I did a little differently than I'm still working. I put spices into a tea ball and threw it in a pot because I didn't want to have to fish anything out. And I knew my friend Crafty Lady, her husband, if he found like a little teeny weeny piece of spice in there, he'd spit it out and that'd be the end of it. And I asked Hungry Hubby to rate it on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being horrible, 10 being, you know, the best tomato soup you ever had in a can. And he goes, oh, way, way better than number 10 being the best he ever had. It would be about a number 25. So go ahead, make it.